Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Football season is in full effect, and since it's Monday night and football is on, beer and snacks are right on time. Please welcome back down to the circle, my girl and beer educator, Jen Price of the Atlanta Beer Boutique, which is opening very soon.
Yes.
Hey, honey.
Hey.
How you doing?
Excellent.
Good. I am fabulous. And you know, we both love football.
Yes.
And there's nothing that goes better with football than beer.
I agree.
And you're going to walk us through it. You know, we start early on college game day.
Well, it's an early day.
It
10:30-ish.
Not
the drinking part, the watching.
The watching, but then the drinking ensues.
First game.
So can we start in the first quarter?
Let's do it.
Let's do it with this beer.
Actually, surprise, surprise, it's not a beer.
Oh.
It's a cider.
Okay.
And I wanted to bring a cider because I always bring beer, but this is a really good gluten-free option.
Oh, that's good.
I have a lot of friends who don't do gluten, and they're like, what can I drink instead of beer? Cider is a great sort of compromise between the two. This is Ginger Reserve by Treehorn Cider.
Ooh.
It's in Marietta, Georgia, and this is a really dry cider. Not
that's
the
good.
Sweet, sugary kind of puckering sweetness that you're used to having from ciders. Very refined.
And you have it in a wine tasting glass. You can do it with both of these glasses.
Well, I would serve it in a champagne flute.
Okay.
Because it's much more like a champagne or a wine than a beer any day.
Yeah, Trina would like that a lot.
It's so good and fresh and clean.
Right.
And it goes well with Asian food. The ginger kind of balances well with a tikka masala, that's chicken. I knew you liked that one, a little saucy. And this washes it down well because ciders are finished very dry.
They
kind of cleanse your palate after bites.
That's yummy.
Yeah, so that's a good one to start with. And if you're tailgating or having those start early too. That's a real good one to start with because it's lower on the alcohol.
It eases you into the day. That's
absolutely
perfect. I'm going to finish that little later. What do we have next?
The second one is Eventide Brewery. These guys are in Grant Park. This is their Honeysuckle Kolsch called Arbor Ale. So this is really neat because it's a German style, very classic German style.
Mm-hmm.
And they're typically very light, very faint in color, aroma, and in taste.
Ooh.
You may get a little bit of honey and honeysuckle.
I do smell the honey.
So they use local honey, local Georgia honey. I love this can. It's designed by my friend Sarah, who works at the brewery.
Yes.
Just very delicate.
So good.
As well as the beer. They go well with anything. This is a good beer for wings, for pizza, for
Gouda mac and cheese.
That I think you would really enjoy. It's
going
to be kind of hard to get in there.
Mm-hmm.
But I love it because the two kind of balance each other out in a way. That's kind of smoky.
Yes.
This is sort of mellow, kind of nullifies it, cleanses your palate again. Another good one to start the day with because it's not very heavy.
Let's talk about temperature of beer.
Yes.
So these two, will they be around the same temperature to serve?
Yes.
Okay.
Very, very cold. So you like ciders and you like Kolsch, beers very cold, 40 degrees.
Yeah. Okay.
That's how they come like off the tap at a brewery or at a restaurant.
Okay.
Super, super cold.
Right.
And you would serve this in a German style flute.
Okay.
This is a footed flute. It almost reminds you of a wine glass
it does.
In a way.
Yeah.
Because these two beers are so pretty in color,
you want to see
these glasses
that.
Showcase the color.
And then it brings out the aroma of the
absolutely.
Beer as well, but because of how the glass is shaped.
Yep, that
absolutely.
Is very true.
See, I know a little something.
I learn. No, I'm so proud of you.
Yes, thanks.
So the third beer is Tucktoberfest by Tucker Brewing. They are on the east side, Tucker's first brewery. And this is a little darker, but it's a German style beer.
Love it.
Called a Marzen. And Marzen beers are the official beers of Oktoberfest. We just started Oktoberfest on Saturday, which is a 2-week celebration. It's actually start off as a celebration of a wedding in Germany, in Bavaria.
Okay.
Yeah, and so this is gonna be very malty, not hoppy at all. No, I love it. It's sort of on the rounder and fuller side for a beer, and it's gonna give you a little malty sweetness.
What temperature would you serve this? A little warmer?
Yeah. Maybe 45 or 50 degrees.
Okay.
Yeah, probably how it is right now. It's probably perfect right now.
Perfect.
German beers vary in color, vary in sort of temperature service. Again, this would be served in a footed flute, a German style, or sometimes you would see it in a mug, actually. Yeah.
That's good, and I have a chicken sausage with this.
Yes, so I liked it with this because I did sort of a beer braised brat. Bratwurst, again, are very traditional German. Very easy to do at a tailgate, on a grill, in the backyard.
That's delicious.
These two go so well together.
They do.
Just the beer and the brat.
I love
it.
I love it.
Classic pairing.
And then the same type of glass for that.
Absolutely. And then a little warmer, like you said.
Yes. All right. What do we have here?
Now, this one is a little funky. I'm going to ask you to...
I like funky.
You know, expand your horizons with this beer.
Okay.
So it is a fruited sour.
Okay.
And actually a wild sour.
Wild sour. Explain what sours are to the people.
So sours can be made in a couple different ways. Mm-hmm. Either because of the fruit that's in it. This has pineapple and some coconut. But it also has something to do with the yeast that's used for it. A wild yeast is actually used.
Ooh.
And back in the day, they would just leave beer vats open and let the natural flora and fauna sort of descend onto the beer and sort of ferment it.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's a wild ale. It has kind of a funky earthiness to it.
That is yummy.
It's really interesting because you may even get a little bit of sort of vinegar.
Right.
To it.
Yes, I do.
Yeah.
And what are we pairing
yeah.
with this?
This is falafel and
mm-hmm.
tahini sauce.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It goes really well with something like this because an earthy
mm-hmm.
bite will
mm-hmm.
help balance it out.
It
or
does.
Kind of accentuate, actually, some
mm-hmm.
of the earthy notes that are in there. Yeah. This is by D9 Brewing. They're from North Carolina. This is 14%.
14%? Oh, yeah, let me have a little bit more on this one.
It's super, super wine-like.
Mm-hmm.
Almost if you're into red wine, you may like this beer.
I do love red wine.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
When we come back, I'm sorry, Mom, for eating with my mouth open. I mean, with food in my mouth. We're going to try the last one, and of course, my other sisters will join us. It's kind of a cocktail slash sangria kind of sort of thingy. Mm-hmm. We'll love it. You'll love it. Stay with us. We are back with my friend and beer connoisseur, 14% beer connoisseur, Jen Price. And we're excited that all the ladies are in now.
Yes.
So we're gonna end the segment with a little cocktail. Tell us about this cocktail.
It is. So this is made by, this is a beer as the base of it, right?
Okay.
It's Tea Palm, which is a wheat pomegranate
Yum.
Ale.
Mm-hmm.
Down Home Brewing, Georgia's first black owned brewery.
Yes.
Ooh, we had this on the show before, but I wanted to mix it up a bit.
Okay.
And make a fall sangria.
Okay.
All right. Because sangrias are really good for sharing, really good for tailgating a party like this party.
Mm-hmm. But
we are.
it's
just a classic sangria mix. You take fruit, you soak it in wine.
Mm-hmm.
That's been soaking for a little bit.
That's a lot of beer.
Yes.
And then you top it really with beer.
Don't lose any.
No, we won't. Just enough.
There you go.
Do
girl.
A little stir.
Right
yes.
now.
She's a pro. With a little
right.
bit of a stir.
All right. Pour
and
us
then
up.
We pour it up, best friend.
Yeah. That nice, pretty head on it.
Yes.
Is that what you call
which
on
is
the
called the foam?
Yeah, that's,
yes.
that's
oh.
what the foam is called. The foam
you
is called the
You can do it,
Meg.
You can do it. You can do it. Yes, you can. You got to try.
No.
And foam is.
Just hold one and make it look pretty.
Yeah, there we go.
Just hold it.
I think you should.
And foam is a good thing, right,
really
best
like
friend?
It is, because foam helps deliver aroma to
you
your
like
nose.
It. Taste it.
And what type of red wine
so
is in
good.
This?
This is just a Merlot. You can use any kind of red wine,
mm-hmm.
as with any sangria, whatever's left over
All
in
right,
your fridge.
All right, let's cheers.
You know?
Cheers.
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 Oh,
cheers. Boom, boom, boom.
Boom, boom, boom.
And cheers to you, best friend. I'm so
Thank
proud
you for
of
having
you.
Me.